So I was talking to someone the other day, and they said they went to a Pentecostal church.
Okay.
And I was like, excuse me. Did you just say Pentecostal church? I'm sorry, don't you mean Pentecostal church? But then I realized there is an actual difference between a Pentecostal church and a Pentecostal church. Anybody in here go to a Pentecostal church? At a Pentecostal church, they play 3-minute worship songs. At a Pentecostal church, they play that one worship song where the chorus keeps repeating for 30 minutes over and over in five-part harmony. At a Pentecostal church, they have a piano backing up the choir. But at a Pentecostal church, they have a Hammond organ backing up the choir. And the organist always plays that one note and holds it until everyone starts shouting and falling out. Ding! The choir director does the nay-nay and hits the folks while the choir puts on a choreographed production with props and matching outfits. I don't even know what hitting the folks is, but that's what I've seen them doing on YouTube. At a Pentecostal church, the choir sings, "Our God Reigns." At a Pentecostal church, the choir sings Prince's Purple Rain. Y'all may have seen that, right? At a Pentecostal church, some of the songs move you and make you cry. At a Pentecostal church, you hear that one note from the organ, and it's like you're at the Olympics. On your marks, get set, go! And there's that one guy who takes off running laps around the church. At a Pentecostal church, they anoint you with a dab of oil. At a Pentecostal church, they splash the whole bottle of totally extra virgin olive oil. Church, there's that one lady who puts her palm on your forehead and starts pushing on it until you fall out and you're like, why are you trying to push me over? At a Pentecostal church, they tell you to lift holy hands unto the Lord. And at a Pentecostal church, they lift their hands over the people.
Okay,
do it with me. And the whole entire church starts doing the wave like you at a baseball game. Right? At a Pentecostal church, they pass about the basket once for the offering.
Okay, okay.
At a Pentecostal church, you march around the church with your offering. You line up in the $50 line, the $50 line, the $1,000 line, and you're all $10,000 because we need to fix the roof on the church. At a Pentecostal church, the ushers wear red jackets. At a Pentecostal church, the ushers wear red jackets, white gloves, and of course on the first Sunday, the deaconesses wear dollies on their head, white gloves, white dresses, and nurses' shoes. At a Pentecostal church, the pastor gives a 45-minute sermon, and the deacon closes out in prayer. At a Pentecostal church, Deacon Jones hears the opening prayer. Assistant Pastor Williams shares the scripture for the altar. Evangelist Somerville gives the announcements. Mother Wilson gives the testimony. Bishop Jenkins preaches for an hour and 15 minutes. Visiting Apostle Meriwether III shares a few words. And then First Lady closes us out. At a Pentecostal church, there's coffee and donuts for first-time visitors and new members in the fellowship hall. At a Pentecostal church, there's fried chicken, mac and cheese, greens, and pound cake in the basement. Somebody's going to ask the answer to pray. At a Pentecostal church, at funerals, everyone files quietly past the casket. At a Pentecostal church, there are life-size pictures of the deceased on easels all around the altar. And everyone takes a selfie in front of the coffin. And Facebook Lives. Yeah, I guess there is a difference between the Pentecostal church and the Pentecostal church.